Hello, Clearwater EdTech Training students. If you're seeing this video, it means that you're considering getting ready to apply for your college credit with Wichita State, which is great. So this video is just a tutorial to walk you through that process and how to do it. The first thing is, if you are still taking classes from me this summer through this program, please do not complete the WSU enrollment until you are done. Again, if this is your last class and you are taking no more, that's fine. If you are still taking additional courses from me throughout the summer, please wait until the very end of that before you apply. You should only do this process one time, not after each course. So in the directions here, you see there is an additional registration link. This is if you wanted to sign up for any more classes this summer. But you'll see that the directions for the summer 24 fall pre-session graduate credit for Clearwater are there. So if we open that document, you'll see that there are two steps. Step number one, every person is going to complete. This is where you're going to request credit through Wichita State for the amount of hours that you took. Again, every single person is going to complete step number one. Okay, so we're going to open that form. And this is simply a form with your last name, your first name. Okay, this does not cost any money to apply for WSU. We're simply applying to apply for our credit hours here. Okay. Question number three, I'm a previous Wichita State market-based tuition student in the last 2 years. So if you've taken a class from me in the last 2 years, that would be a yes, and you would enter your WSU ID. Okay. If you have taken it maybe through another district that offers the same program, you could also do that. If you have not done that, okay, we're not going to check that box. Okay, so we would not check that there. We would not have a WSU ID. Whatever your email address is that you'd like to receive the correspondence at, okay? And then when you scroll down here, you'll see several options. For these courses in the summer, the EdTech, we are checking box number one, the summer 24 professional development, this CAS 750D effective instructional practice, okay? Do not check any of these bottom four boxes. These are additional credits from our Clearwater School District that are not part of this. So again, we're checking the top box. The last part, we're going to scroll down. We're going to sign by typing your name, and you're going to choose the number of credit hours that you're applying for. So for the EdTech classes, that could be anywhere from 1 to 5 credit hours, depending on how many classes you've taken. If you took all 5 classes, it's 5 credit hours. If you only took 2, that's 2. Then we're going to go ahead and we're going to submit that form. That will notify WSU that you are applying for credit. That will trigger me verifying with them that you have completed that credit, and we will start that process. If you are new to the market-based tuition program, as indicated in the form on step number one, you need to do step number two. Okay, so if this is the first time that you have taken any courses with me in this Wichita State program, you are going to complete step number two. If you have previously taken classes with me or with another school district in this program with Wichita State, you do not have to complete step number two. Okay, so if you are going to have to complete step number two, you'll open that. And this is where you're going to fill out some more actual information for Wichita State about getting those an account with them so that you can get your transcript, so that you can pay for your credit at the end of the summer. This process does not cost any money to apply, but you're going to go through and you're going to fill out that. On those directions, if you scroll down in the second page, it walks you through exactly question by question how you're going to respond to those. Pay close attention, particularly to section 4 or number 4 about the program selection. This is the fall 2024 term, even though these are summer classes. Wichita State calls this fall pre-session. So when you come down here, you see the program is selected. Your admission type is going to be domestic, non-degree B. Again, those are right here, okay, in these here. The program selection, you'll look right here and it tells you that the program selection is we're fall 24, we're non-degree B, and we're learning and instructional design. Okay, so when we come up here, we'll come down, we're learning and instructional design, and we are not summer 24, we are fall of 24. Okay, the district is Clearwater, and then you can continue to fill these out this way. Okay. So, and this is how, what helps you. You can look up your license for linking those to your licensure renewal, those kinds of things. Again, you are completing this process if this is the first time that you've taken classes with me through our program. If you're a returner and have done this already, you do not have to repeat this process. You only have to fill out step number one. Okay. Once you have completed this, you're going to get a verification email from Wichita State verifying your enrollment. You will not, until the end of August, get an email from them to pay for your tuition. Okay, so you do not owe Wichita State any money until the end of the summer semester, start of the fall semester, which is roughly late August teens. You will receive an email from them at that point with directions on how to pay for your credit. And if you'd like a transcript at that point, then you can do that. If you have any questions, please let me know. Hopefully these tutorials and these steps are helpful. Thank you.